Lieutenant Worf is recovering in sick bay. The wound was not severe.
Dead? Injured?
3 dead, 4 wounded.
Another millisecond, there'd have been a big dust cloud orbiting Rudy instead of the Enterprise.
Why? I just asked if they would talk.
You have your answer, Riker.
Sir, the next time the Ansada use their dimensional jump, we should be able to get a fix on the power source.
Worf went down. I don't know if he's alive or dead. And there were other casualties.
Was Wes on the bridge?
Yes. He took cover. I didn't see any more than that. But you were all right, though.
Yes, they needed a doctor.
The side effects of the transport.
Yes.
We're getting closer to tracing their movements. Actually, it was Wesley who put us onto this dimensional jump of theirs. He has been extraordinary, Beverly. He's going to make a very fine officer.
He's had good role models. I'm sorry if I'd only gone back to the ship.
Should have beamed you up.
You wouldn't dare.
Oh, yes, I would, and should.
Without my permission?
If you don't follow orders.
If you'd give reasonable orders, I'd obey.
Doctor, I will be the judge of what is reasonable.
There aren't any exits to the surface.
So the only way out is by the transporter. Or the dimensional jump.
A mode of travel I'd encourage you to avoid. It's killing them.
They're mad.
I don't know anymore.
The difference between a madman and a committed man willing to die for a cause, it's all become blurred over the last few days.
Beverly, I don't have to remind you of the psychological impact of being a hostage.
I know, I understand that. But their leader, Finn, he's not what you'd expect.
No, he's certainly not what I would expect. Without cause or reason, he and his little band of outlaws have attacked my ship.
But he did have reasons. The medical supplies, the arrests. Jean-Luc, if we really examined our role in all this, we
Beverly, would... you were arguing for a man who may have murdered your son.
I didn't kill your son, Beverly. We weren't able to destroy the ship. We had to settle for him. She wouldn't even tell me her name. I call her Doctor.
You have made a grave miscalculation.
Oh?
You have assaulted a Federation starship, killed and wounded several members of her crew, kidnapped 2 of her officers, and you don't expect a response?
On the contrary, I'm counting on it.
You want Federation involvement?
Captain, Federation has a lot to admire in it. But there's a hint of moral cowardice in your dealings with non-aligned planets. You're doing business with a government that is crushing us, and you say you're not involved. You're very, very much involved. You just don't want to get dirty.
You accuse us of cowardice while you plant bombs in shadows.
I am fighting the only war that I can against an intractable enemy. Now I'm fighting a big war against a more powerful adversary. Can't you see how that helps me?
I'm afraid I can't.
He's added another chair to the negotiating table.
You added the chair, Captain. I am simply forcing you to sit in it. The Federation will quickly tire of our little war. They'll want you back. They will want to get as far from Rutia as they can. And I will not make it easy. Eventually, the Federation will force the government into making concessions. And then a few more, and then a few more. Until we can finally reach an honorable agreement that saves face for all sides. Except we win.
You understand, I will not cooperate with you in any way.
You've already cooperated, Captain. Just by coming here.
brains like the beans, yeah, yeah.